KineMaster. Hey, welcome back to Mastering KineMaster. So this was going to be a tutorial about the new stabilizer by KineMaster, but because I'm here to help you guys and because I do love KineMaster so much with this KineMaster channel, I have to be honest as well to say that I do not think it's a good product. I don't think it stabilizes well, and I think that it's buggy. I'm gonna go through with a tutorial to show you because I don't want you thinking you're doing something wrong, but my number one recommendation is right now I won't be using it, which is sad because I could, and I have to say I don't think you're gonna get the results that you want. That said, like and subscribe, come back for really good content about KineMaster. I still love KineMaster, and follow me through for the walkthrough and tutorial and to understand what it does and what it doesn't do. So if you want to join me, see you on the other side, or I'll see you the next time. First and most important, the results just aren't that impressive. This is the unstabilized version, and then coming up is the stabilized version. Now, this is a pretty standard shaky video of me with a cup of fruit in my hand, and so the difference between the two outputs is hardly noticeable. I'm going to do this as I stacked them on top of each other, and so you can see I'm going to change the opacity in the one versus the other so you can see a little bit better what's going on. Now there is a difference, however, if you scroll through, really the majority of the shakiness is still there in the cup, in the walk, in everything about it. And when push comes to shove, this was relatively unstable. I exaggerated a little bit, but I tried it in other fashions, and if I didn't move that much, there wasn't that much adjustment. If I moved a whole lot, then it didn't really do anything, so it's really not that useful of a tool, even if it worked perfectly. If you do want to try it out, just go to your app store and search for Video Stabilizer for KineMaster, load it in, and there's one button, just that orange button. You hit that, very simple. It loads your video library, you select the clip that you want, and then you hit the next button when you select the video that you want, and then it goes into processing. And processing can be quite some time. This was only an 8-second clip, so it was fast, but with 30 seconds, it took a while to do something. And then what pops up onto your screen is, you can see here they're comparing them, and to me these things look identical to me. So then you can go ahead, and if you want to save it, then you go ahead and press that save button that's up at the top. So now we're on the save screen. So you do either low, medium, or high. Looks easy. The button on the right I'm going to tell you about but not do is that it saves a watermarked copy. I pay for KineMaster, so I don't want to have my copies of my stabilized video watermarked and saved to my device. So I'm going to try the button on the left. Now what the button on the left does is incredibly bad and weird. What it does is it creates a single video file name that it overwrites any file of the same name, and it's the only way, and so there's only ever going to be one stabilized video, which is so strange. It's overwriting right now the content that was there before, and then even worse, it's going to shut down KineMaster, open up a new project, and then have the project be this project that is only just that one stabilized video. So in order to use it, I have to export it again, bring it into my other project. It is so cumbersome and such a pain. I can never see myself wanting to use it. And so the workflow is bad, the output is bad, and it's just frustratingly bad because it's something that I wanted. So that's really, unfortunately, what I have to say about this product.
So that's what I got now. I don't foresee them being able to change much of it in the near future because of how deep in the system the way that it works is. If it does, again, I'll pull the video down. Otherwise, to the positive, get out there and make some cool stuff with the awesome features that KineMaster does actually have, and I'll see you next time on some tutorial to do something actually cool and fun. Remember, like and subscribe, and catch you the next time. KineMaster.